May 27, 2016, about 50 peppers have been taken out. This terrapin was not eating at all for the last 4 days due to infection of the cloaca, as evident by the x-ray and in the earlier video. But now you can see, about 2 hours after removal of those stones and the dead egg, the terrapin actually is eating. You can see, he's really hungry. And put some pellets in. He's eating already. And as you can see from here, these are the pellets. These are the pellets removed from the cloaca. And there's one dead egg shell. You just throw some pellets in and you can see that after removal of all these stones from the cloaca. Yeah, so it's a good news. And also, of course, we warm up the terrapin and it feels happier when it's warm. Then this fellow must eat also. This fellow, is he eating or not? Throw one in and see. This one has got shell rot actually. Now you see, it's really eating. So when they are healthy, they are well, they will eat. You see? This one is shell rot. You can see the white patches. It's been hospitalized for 1 day. You can see how really hungry. Now this fellow, for the last 4 days, have not been eating at all. So brought in this morning, and I had an x-ray done. You can see the other video. And after the x-ray, then we had to take the forceps to pull out the cloaca. From the cloaca, about 50 pebbles. These are pebbles. And you can see also one egg, deformed egg, which was also stuck inside the cloaca. So with this obstruction, the terrapin of course couldn't pee and poo. So the last 4 days it lost appetite. Now around 2 weeks ago, she was having egg bound. That means one egg stuck in the cloaca. And so she wasn't able to eat and drink at that time as well. This is another patient, but this one is was not eating due to infection of the shell. You can see the shell. The shell has white spots. After treatment, cleaning the shell, applying ointment, and putting in clean water, you can see that this terrapin with shell rot has regained its appetite. This is a hatchling actually, it's not much, it's not very big. Judy, more food. So it's good that this impacted cloaca, give out 20 pieces, were in front of him. So they let him eat as much as he can, so that he regains his energy and goes home. Well, you haven't seen such a hungry terrapin. 4 days he has not been eating. That doesn't even wait to swallow, you see. It just, and that's how he ate the peppers as well. Those peppers were in the tank in his aquarium. So the owner will not be putting any more pebbles. And the grid on the left will be a deformed egg, which was also pulled out from the cloaca. So it's quite a joy to see a patient not eating for 4 days, diagnosed with evidence from x-rays, dorsal ventral x-ray of impaction of the colon or the rectum with at least 50 pebbles and also a deformed egg shell or egg. And after 4 days of not eating, the owners brought it here for treatment. So what Dr. Daniel does is they use a forceps to pull out the pebbles from the cloaca or the vent, or inside the vent, one by one. And according to him, the terrapin also nearly collapsed and died during the process. And this is quite obvious that it's in great distress when you pull the pebbles out from the rectum. Well, at least it doesn't need direct surgery. And now the appetite has returned. So it should be good news for the owner as well. About 5 years old and was egg bound. That means the egg stuck in the cloaca, a fully formed egg stuck in the cloaca about 2 weeks ago. And Dr. Daniel used a string to suck out the egg yolk and the egg contents, and later on pull out the egg shell. After that, the next day the terrapin was eating, so I sent it home, and then it was okay for the next few days, until the last 4 days when she did not eat. The reason being, I suspect impaction of the colon due to the passage of the pebbles down from the small intestines or the higher part, and then all getting stuck together with this deformed egg, all stuck in the cloaca or the vent. And so, as you can see in the x-ray, they really couldn't come up without veterinary assistance. I mean, if you just leave it alone, the obstruction will stop the passage of urine as well as any stools, and of course the terrapin, which is 5 years old, would then die. But 4 days of loss of appetite, but now today, after treatment this morning, the terrapin is okay. Now we look at this shell rot, hatchling, came in yesterday, and you can see it's quite active now. I had just eaten as well, so it probably stay here for about 2 days more and then it goes home. Okay, eating already. Eating 20 pellets already.
Then
eat. Eaten already.
Call owner already.
Yeah, call already.
Okay. What we did, we use the saline to flush it
out. Flush out.
Still.
Other, no faucet?
You put in the faucet actually.
Yeah, have to.
But cannot do too much, so just turn and then flush. Keep flushing until everything come out. Turn. But then
he's eating, right? He's eating. No, he's eating. I did video him. Yeah. It was very surprising. He's very hungry. Ask Judy some more. More. Normally this one can eat 40 to 50, you know.
Sure.
For his size, put in front of his mouth here. Yeah. Just put down or lower down a bit. Since he's so hungry, 4 days not eating. You see? Yeah.
Suddenly!
No, because
no more stones.
No more stones, yeah.
Maybe you throw a stone 5 years ago.
You eat stones.
She still has
come some more.
The stone, she doesn't feel hungry.
Yeah, only after that.
No, because you cannot pee. The whole thing stuck, you see. Obstruction, they call it. Obstruction of the...
Always feeling full.
Wow. Everything stuck.
Yeah, I'm still full. Wow.
Yeah, the gas also, yeah. Then they form gas. That's why you see the x-ray, there's some
gas. Eating.
This one you got the video with your camera.
Did you video? Hey, I need to go already.
You go out. Finish already, right?
Only 30 coming only.
No more already, right?
I said the key, just now she got the key.
This one, right? Judy, this one?
What?
Bring in. Yeah, I'm finished. Yeah, bring in.
Bring
what kind of? Never mind, anyway. You don't finish already, right? Then dry, yeah. Dry overnight again. Dry. The well beloved therapy and well taken care, you can see. At this, supposed to be 5 years old, quite good size. You can see the shell well formed. And this is Singapore Theraprene. And had a big aquarium tank, glass tank actually. I think it's enough, about 40 pellets. Still eating, imagine. It's about 6:30 PM now, May 27, 2016. This tavern came in at about 9:30 AM this morning with complaint of not eating for the past 4 days, lethargy, and the temperature was very low, about 36 and below. The vents was loose, I would call it. So as if the therapist was trying to pass out, trying to strain out some pebbles or stones, but couldn't do it. So X-ray showed that the stones and pebbles were stuck in the cloaca, the lower colon. And from here you can see, yeah, you can see the stones taken out here, and the dead, the deformed shell. May 27, 2016, infection of colon in a 5-year-old female terrapin who had egg bound around 2 to 3 weeks ago and has swallowed lots of pebbles from the tank. Pebbles were used as a substrate for this therapy.